Hello, everyone. Welcome to Morning English. This is Flair.
Hi, guys. This is Summer. 欢迎大家收听早安英文。
Hello, welcome to Morning English. 早安英文呢是一个为大家免费提供英语教学的频道，每天都会更新。如果你想获得关于英语听说读写的内容，我们都会在这个频道更新。我们的目标是帮助全球的华人学好英语。如果你觉得还不错的话，记得给我们订阅哦。另外，点开小铃铛，这样的话就不会错过其他任何学习视频啦。对了，如果你想获取本节课的完整版笔记，在视频简介或者评论区领取哦。你也可以给这个视频点赞，点赞就相当于自动保存啦。
贝贝，是不吃鱼，对吧？
嗯，
不管是清蒸啊、红烧啊，或者是剁椒鱼头 You just can't stand it.
Right. I'm not a fish person. I don't like the taste or the smell of fish. Except for cod and salmon. 但是鳕鱼和三文鱼我还是挺爱吃的。
Okay, yeah, I know how much you like salmon. Alright, so here I've got a phrase about fish for you. See if you know the meaning.
Okay, what is it?
Fishwife.
Fishwife?
Yeah.
鱼的老婆吗、我猜肯定不是字面意思啊。So, does it mean a woman who married to a weird guy or something? I don't know about that.
Okay, so a fishwife actually means a woman with a loud voice and bad manners, and is used in a disapproving way.
I see. A woman with a loud voice. 指的是啊，这个女人呢，嗓门很大、bad manners, 然后呢，也不怎么有礼貌，比较粗鲁。
对，这个 fishwife, 它的来源呢其实是指一个卖鱼的女人。你想在大街上卖鱼，你需要大声的吆喝，说话呢也比较豪放粗俗啊。所以这个 fishwife 慢慢的就有了泼妇这个意思，现在就是个贬义词。
Got it. So for example, we can say she was screaming like a fishwife. 意思就是啊，她跟个泼妇一样大喊大叫的。
对的啊。那其实英语中啊，和 fish 相关的表达真的还挺多的啊、而且也都很常见。So in today's podcast, let's find out more phrases about this word, fish.
Okay.To talk about fish, I can do that.
Okay, 那口语中呢，大家会用这个 fish 来描述不同的人。比如我们刚刚的 fishwife 是泼妇 and also this phrase, cold fish.
Cold fish, yeah, it refers to an unfriendly person who seems to have no strong feelings. 说一个人是 cold fish, 意思就是说啊，他比较冷漠，也不会表达自己特别强烈的情感。Like he's cold, unfriendly, and distant.
Right. 那这个词啊，可能就会有同学想，我是不是可以翻译成高冷啊？但这里其实不太合适，因为高冷它不算贬义词嘛。但这个 cold fish 它其实是带贬义的。It's kind of an insult.
Okay. So if you don't like someone and he's being really indifferent, then you can say he's a cold fish.
Yeah, exactly.比如有一个朋友遇到麻烦了需要帮忙啊、小明就特别的冷漠而且还冷嘲热讽的 In this case, I would call him a cold fish
Okay, other than cold fish, we also have these two idioms、Odd fish and queer fish
Yes, odd fish, queer fish 这两个表达只要你认识前面这个词啊你就能猜出意思了 Odd, O-D-D, 意思就是奇怪的 Queer, Q-U-E-E-R意思也是奇怪的，所以这两个表达都是指怪人，一个人特别古怪。
Yeah, someone who is slightly strange or crazy.
Yeah.
But these expressions are a bit old-fashioned, so you won't hear them being used that often.
对，这两个词还是有点年代感啊，所以现在年轻人可能用的比较少。不过呢，你还是看使用的场景。比如我还想起一个啊，就是只有在这个地方，这个单词才有意义，就是在监狱里呢叫一个人 fish，
是不是越狱看多了
？Yeah, you got me. Michael Scofield 就是米帅，他才进监狱的时候呢，就被那些人叫做 fish。So being called a fish in prison means you're a new prisoner. 意思就是你是监狱里新来的。
Yeah, hey fish, do whatever I told you to. Otherwise, it's gonna look ugly.
Yeah, you sound scary.
Okay, 那刚刚我们讲的 fish 是可以描述不同的人啊。那 fish 呢，还有一些词组是跟吃的相关的。比如啊，我现在就蛮想吃鱼柳的。Now I have a craving for some fish fingers.
啊，是那种炸的鱼条是吗？
Right.
我也想吃。Fish fingers finger 就是手指的那个 finger， 它还可以指那种条状的呀，长条的事物，比如说长条的面包 a finger of toast， 巧克力条也是 chocolate fingers。
对，所以鱼柳就是 fish fingers。
嗯，
不过在美式英语当中啊，更常见的呢是这个词 stick， so that's fish stick in American English
I'll take it, whether it's fish fingers or fish sticks. 我来者不拒啊。
Yeah, join the club. Okay, now next phrase. Have bigger fish to fry.
Have bigger fish to fry. 哇，这个表达又把我听饿了。Fry, F-R-Y, 就是油炸、油煎的意思。
Mm-hmm.
Have bigger fish to fry. 字面意思是我还有一条更大的鱼要去煎呢。
但其实这个表达跟吃东西没什么关系啊。
Mm-hmm.
It means you have other things to do, especially more important things. 意思呢是很委婉的表示，哎，我还有更重要的事要去处理，不能奉陪了。
对，是一句很委婉的告别语啊。For example, your friends are having a lively conversation, but you need to go. Then you can say, sorry, I have bigger fish to fry, so I've got to go.
嗯，虽然现在我们在录节目啊，嗯，但是呢，我刚刚收到条短信啊，发现我昨天买的彩票中奖了，哎，我得去领奖了。I have bigger fish to fry, I gotta go.
我觉得啊，你这不是 have bigger fish to fry, but have a bigger daydream to make. 就是白日做梦。
总有一天梦想会成真的。
或者呢？你是喝多了酒说胡话，因为讲到这个喝酒，记得我们之前就讲过一个词组啊，也是和 fish 相关， to drink like a fish，
right.
就是说这个人超能喝，
someone who can drink a lot or has high alcohol tolerance，
yeah， 是的。 OK， 那这个 fish 还有一个很经典的表达，如果你有朋友分手了，这句话就特别合适。
嗯哼，是不是？天涯何处无芳草，
mm-hmm.
There are plenty more fish in the sea.
Exactly. 这句话字面意思是海里还有很多鱼，其实就是天涯何处无芳草啊。Even if your relationship has ended, there are many other people you can still have a relationship with.
Right. Don't cry over the breakup. There are plenty more fish in the sea.
Alright, 那最后啊，我们要不要来讲讲这句也是很经典的和鱼相关的表达。
Mm-hmm.
中文是授人以鱼不如授人以渔。
Good idea. So in English, that is, give a man a fish and you feed him for one day. Teach a man to fish and you feed him for a lifetime.
这么一对比，我感想就是中文比较简洁啊。
是的啊。但是呢，英文这个句子它表达的也是蛮清晰的啊。
嗯，
Give a man a fish， 哎，给他一条鱼。You feed him for a day， 你能让他饱餐一天。Teach a man to fish， fish 呢，这里是用作动词表示钓鱼了。
嗯，
You feed him for a lifetime， 你让他一辈子都不饿肚子。
对。那也希望我们的节目里就教会大家的不仅仅是一些词组，更重要的呢是养成学习的好习惯，然后还有随时随地用英语的这个意识。
Yeah, that's what we are trying to do here. OK, 那我们今天就和大家讲了这些和 fish 相关的表达，大家都学到位了吗？可以在评论区造句给我们留言哦。
Yeah, and that's all we have for today.
Hello, welcome to Morning English. 早安英文呢是一个为大家免费提供英语教学的频道，每天都会更新。如果你想获得关于英语听说读写的内容，我们都会在这个频道更新。我们的目标是帮助全球的华人学好英语。如果你觉得还不错的话，记得给我们订阅哦。另外点开小铃铛，这样的话就不会错过其他任何学习视频啦。对了，如果你想获取本节课的完整版笔记，在视频简介或者评论区领取哦。你也可以给这个视频点赞，点赞就相当于自动保存啦。
So thank you so much for listening. This is Flair.
This is Summer. See you next time.
Bye. Bye.